Greetings, greetings, humans. I have drinking way too much sugar water today, so Coca-Cola voice, I think you would call it. Don't drink all that sugar sodas and stuff like that. It's not good for you. Just, you know, sparkly water. That's cool. So I have my face up here because most of this is just going to be me be talking, but I am going to give you guys some virtual aids also here. But I want to talk about what makes a distribution successful. So if you look at, you know, like what makes, not that this, again, DistroWatch is not like a success meet or something like that, but if you just look at like the, what makes the biggest distribution or the distributions you see are up and going and stuff like that and stay there, we keep seeing distributions that goes up and down, and then you don't see them anymore. Garada or Quada, what it's called here, is one of those that's going up and then it's going down in popularity. Because it's new, it's fancy, it looks cool, but it's really not bringing anything to the table. And then you have, you know, distributions like PopOS, Elementary OS, Manjaro, Arch, Debian, Fedora, they keep staying mostly used. So why is that? Why do we... What makes a distribution long-lasting and successful? And I kinda research this a little bit because I'm a nerd like that. I like figuring those things out. And a lot of you guys may not like what I'm going to say, but if you look at the what those distributions are doing that stays relevant and consistent, this is kind of the things they are doing. So I have like, what is this? 1, 2, 3, 4. Four simple terms that we can kind of put our heads around. There's a lot of things in there, lock plays in a little bit, you know, came out at the right time, at, you know, with the right features and stuff like that. There's always lock, always have a play in anything in life, sometimes more than others. But let's try and do like, if you want to be a contender in the distribution market, because we see a lot of people making distributions and they get fed up if the distribution is not taking off. They are getting frustrated that they're not getting the users they want and stuff like that. When I look at those distributions or talk to the developers of those distributions, they are basically missing either one or all of these things that I have on, no, that's not it, on this text here, which is basically, it's not, you know, like if you follow this, you will automatically be successful with a distribution, but it's something I have noticed that all of the distributions that are relevant and have been popular for the longest time are sharing. So let's get into it. Strong leadership. I know this sounds crazy in the Linux world where everything has to be free and open source and we all sharing ideas and we all helping each other and stuff like that. Projects functions best if you have a strong leadership. There needs to be someone that can take the helm and say, this is how we do it, or this is not how we do it. Also, there needs to be one, it don't have to be one guy, but you know, there needs to be a strong leadership. So if things goes tits up, there are places people can direct, you know, the problems. The problem with not having a strong leadership, or if everyone is kind of the CEO, is that most of your time, and you see this in a lot of forums, you see this in a lot of, especially distribution that's been dormant and then a new development team is taking it up. Because it's not one guy that are taking on the leadership role or a couple of guys, they are using a lot of time talking about who they should talk about filling in that leadership role, because either they all want it or nobody wants it, or the people they want to do it don't want to do it. So if you don't have someone that are kind of steering the project or the distribution or whatever, the software, what do we call it, you end up in a lot of limbo where it's just talk, and nothing really happens. You need someone to say, you know what? It could be like a couple of guys who could have like a board of directors or, you know, a council or something like that. But you need someone that can say, okay, this is enough. We have listened to all of this. We evaluated all of this. We need to do something now. You know, we need to take action because, sadly enough, in open source, because it's so open and everyone thinks that they are the next Linus Torvalds, we get a lot of talk and not a lot of action. So what I see when I'm looking at strong distributions that has been here for a long time or are rising really, really fast is that they have a strong leadership. They know who the boss is. They know who to come and yell at if something goes wrong. There is someone to take the responsibility of directing and steering this boat. The next one, again, I spelled this badly. I'm dyslexic, so my spelling is out of the water. But here, clear direction. The distributions that do the best, that gets a lot of users that keep being relevant, they also have a clear direction. I call it a mission plan, it's not a word that I have, you know, invented, but it's a business word. I think I learned it in some business courses I took 10 years ago, something like that. But not only do those distributions have a good strong leadership, they also have a clear direction of what is this distribution set out to do. What is the meaning with this distribution? Are we going to be for medical use? Or are we going to be a newbie distribution? Or are we going to fill in, you know, just a generalized good Linux distribution where a newcomer can use it and advanced people can use it? Most Linux distributions, if you go on to DistroWatch here, that are failing behind, or if you go on to SearchForge, that are like, why are we not getting any traction and stuff like that? 99% of them have no clear direction. They are basically just Ubuntu, GNOME, Debian, name a distribution, and then they just reskin it with another, icon theme or GTK3 theme or Qt theme. That's not a direction. That's just, oh, let's make Arch more pretty, or let's make, Debian more pretty. That's also why Garada here, how the hell you are pronouncing it. It's not talked so much about as it was when it came out. Everyone and their grandmother was talking about it a couple months ago. Now I rarely hear anything about it because they figured out, well, it's basically just, I can't remember if it's Manjaro or Arts, that's just themed up with a little bit of extra application. Arts. Yeah, it looks pretty. But this is not a direction. We want to look pretty. That's not a direction for a distribution. So you need to figure out what is your mission statement. What is the purpose of this distribution? Like I said, are we a general distribution? Are we a server distribution? Are we focusing on the medical market? Are our direction to get more people into Linux? What is the direction? You need a clear direction, and you need to spend a lot of time figuring out what this is, because once you set that direction, it's really, really hard to change it. You can't go and say, oh, we want to be a medical distribution, a distribution focusing on the medical field. And then 6 months down the line, because it's not working out for you, oh, now we want to be a gaming distribution. And when that's not working out for you, like 2 months or a year down the line, okay, now we want to be a generalized Linux distribution like Ubuntu and Debian is to some extent. Where Debian's direction is stability and security. Arch's direction is the latest and greatest and rolling release. That's what they are. That's their direction. They want everything to be as up to date as possible. Meaning you're getting latest and greatest. They need a good direction. And if you don't have that, and you have not spent a lot of time figuring this one out, you probably not go anywhere. And it kind of also, like I said, these three things here kind of goes a little bit hand in hand. Filling a market or finding a niche. There are so many distributions out there. If you go in and we look at DistroWatch here, where is it? And this is just on DistroWatch. There are probably 3 or 4 times more distributions not on DistroWatch, okay? If you're not doing something these guys are not doing, you are basically irrelevant. You need to do something other distributions are not doing. You need to fill a market that's there. You need to figure out what is missing in the Linux distribution market right now. Again, that goes a little bit hand in hand with your direction. So again, if let's just talk medical here. So if you want to focus on the medical field, What in the medical field right now is Linux not supplying or filling out? What needs in the medical field Alene is not feeling right now. So you need to find and fill that market. And also basically validate if there's any reasons to do it. Like, does it make sense from a financial standpoint? Does it make sense from a... This is something I'm willing to invest a lot of spare time into. You need to evaluate those things. So you need to figure out how to find a niche or fill a market. If you want to be a gaming distribution, what niche or what market within gaming are other Linux distribution not fulfilling right now? Again, these all kind of goes a little bit hand in hand. Have a strong leadership that can remember and keep track of the direction you want the distribution to take within the market and the need within that market that the distribution is trying to fill. Again, who wants another KDE Arts distribution with another theme on it? Who want another Ubuntu distribution, GNOME Ubuntu distribution with another icon set on it? Nobody wants that. It's not fulfilling a market. It's not fulfilling a niche. It's not having a clear direction, and apparently not a strong leadership either. And that's why a lot of distributions sadly won't make it. That's also why the lifespan of distributions are really, really small. I think average is 2 or 3 years before they start to die out. And that's because they're not filling a market or filling a niche. They don't have a clear direction and they don't have a strong leadership. You need to figure out what you want with your distribution again here. And that's on the leadership role. So the leadership needs to figure out, or the author, or you know, the inventor of the distribution, what is the direction we want to take? Is there a market for it? Or what market do we want to take that direction in? Like I said, medical, gaming, general use and stuff like that. And then when you find that market, well, is there a subsection within that market that Linux is not fulfilling or being fulfilled by other distributions? Then go fill that, because if you're just taking Ubuntu and theming Ubuntu, you are basically competing with Ubuntu. And just the fact that you're changing the icon set don't make you a better Ubuntu distribution. If you're taking Arts and putting a desktop environment on it and giving it a Keller Mouse installer, if that's all you do, you are not really competing that much with Arts. You're basically just Arts installed more convenient. And there's a little bit of a market for that out there, but it's not massively, okay? The last one is you have to stand out. This one here, depending on what your direction is and what market needs, you know, what needs within a market you want to fulfill, is kind of important and not so important. So let's say you're in the medical field again. You want to fulfill a niche or a part of the medical field market that Linux is not fulfilling whatsoever. You kind of don't have to stand out. You just have to provide the tools and the software that those medical people or what that part of the medical field needs. That's all you do. And by doing that, you're standing out. But again, if you're just taking Ubuntu and theming it and calling it Bob's Distribution, you're not standing out. If you're just taking Arts, theming it and putting it out there, you're not standing out. If you're just taking Debian, putting a theme on it, putting it out there, you're not standing out. So how do one stand out? Well, give the user something they cannot find on any other distributions that you're competing with. And you're like, oh, we are not competing with each other. You are. Let's say there are 1 million Linux users. The distribution you're making right now is not going to give Linux more users. That's distributions like SUSE, Debian, Arts, and all of these big hitters. They bring in new users. So you're competing for the existing user base. And if you're not standing out or giving them something that they can't get anywhere else, you probably will not make it. There are, again, outliers, but for the most part, you will not last long and you probably will not make it. That's, again, this here standing out is the main reason I rarely do Linux distributions reviews or look at, because they are all the same nowadays. They're just an Arch respin, a Debian respin, a Ubuntu respin with nothing to bring. So why should I even install it? I'm not getting better hardware capabilities or hardware support. I'm not getting software that I am not getting under the parent distribution. All I'm getting is an ISO with some other pre-installed software on it and another theme. I can do that with each of those distributions, Arch Debian, whatever it's based on, within 5 to 10 minutes myself. So why should I re-download an ISO, nuke my already existing installation, and install their version of Linux if I can just customize the one I already have? Makes no sense. And I think this is the one that most people forget about. They kind of know a little bit about this one. They kind of have a little bit of, you know, what they want to do with the distribution. They kind of think that they have found a niche that they want to fill within the market they're in, but they are not standing out. They are basically just taking, again, Debian, Ubuntu, Linux from scratch, Arch, and then they're just taking everything within the repo that they want. Not all of the repos, of course, but they're taking the software they want from the repo, putting it into an ISO, and then now we are making a new respin. And then they get, oh, why are people not using us? Why are YouTubers not talking about us and stuff like that? Well, standing out is important. You need to give them something you cannot get anywhere else. Even if you're looking at small projects. So, Esnic, for example. What makes Esnic's easy art to stand out from any other Linux Arch respin? His install script. That's it. That's the only thing that stands out within his distribution. Nothing else. There are plenty of other people doing the exact same thing that he's doing. They just don't have his install script. So people will choose his distribution because they like the way it's installed via his install script. If they just want a plain old Calamouse installer, they can go with Endeavor OS, Salient OS, Arco Linux. Should I go on? It's his install script that makes it stand out. Not much, but a little bit. And that's enough that he can sustain a kind of good install base or download base on a weekly basis. And that also means he has a strong leadership. He's the CEO. There's a direction. It's the script that's the direction. It's fulfilling a market. People want a more convenient way to install Arch still. And it's standing out. If it didn't stand out, if he only gave you the Calamouse installer, I don't think it will have been doing as well as it does right now. I honestly don't think so. So you need all of these things. That these are the common denominators for almost all successful Linux distributions, small or big. The bigger you want your distributions to be, the stronger your leadership have to be, the stronger or the clearer the direction have to be, and the bigger a market you want to fulfill. So again, with Esnic's install script, the market that he's trying to fulfill with a more convenient way of installing Arch is almost starting to be oversaturated. Had he done this 5 or 6 years ago, he would have been one of the biggest Arch Linux distributions out there. Right now, that's maybe not in the card, but there is still a little market forward, or a little niche forward within the Arch community. So he found a market or a niche, and he's fulfilling it. And because he's using his own script, he's standing out. So if you want to be bigger, you want to find a bigger market within a market, you know, like, oh, we want to make Arch Linux. So that's kind of what Manjaro did. We want to make Arch Linux more approachable, more usable and stuff like that. Because a lot of people want that. They want a more convenient Arch install, a more stable Arch experience. Again, strong leadership, clear direction. They're fulfilling a market. This market is just way bigger than, let's say, the market Esnic is trying to fulfill. And of course, they are standing out with their own tools and stuff like that. I hope this makes a little bit sense. What I want you to take away from this video is that if you want to make a distribution and you want to make it a career, or you want to take it a little bit away from this hobby, yes, you know, oh, this is something I do for fun in my mom's basement or in the attic while the wife is cooking down below, or while the husband is yelling at the kids down below kind of thing. You need at least these four things. You need strong leadership, clear direction, filling a market or niche, and standing out. And the more or the bigger the market you're trying to is that you're trying to fulfill, the bigger growth potential you also have, because there are more users that want the thing that you're trying to fulfill. So if only, like, you know, there's one user that want, you know, something that you're trying to fulfill within a market, you only have one potential user, where if you're trying to fulfill a niche within a market where thousands of people want that, you have a bigger pool of users potentially. So look this as like, I'm going to use this to take the direction of my distribution to another place. I want to be more than just a hobby distribution that I do for fun for myself. Look at this and go research what other distributions are doing. Sign up for their mailings list. Look at their development mailings list and see how they are handling conflict support when they are talking about that. Because a lot of these big distributions, Debian, Ubuntu and so on, they are talking about all of these things here. What is the direction of the distribution? Do this fits in with the direction of the distribution? Are we fulfilling a need or just doing this for our own sake? And are we still relevant, standing out? Are we still bringing something to the table no one else is doing? This is basically, again, if you analyze this as an autistic asshole as I am, this is what you will come out with. This is like some of the four things that I would say is the common denominator that that basically makes a lot of distributions, or makes the distributions that are doing well do well and be relevant for a lot of years, is that they are basically following these kind of rules here. I hope this makes sense. So use this as a tool to figure out, now I want to take this 100% seriously. I want to make it a career, or I want to make it, you know, something that is more than just something I show together a weekend. Not use all of them, but try and put this into your project, you know. What is the direction I want to take my distribution? Am I fulfilling a market and needs, and how big is that market and needs I'm trying to fulfill? Am I standing out from all those, from this massive amount of distribution that's already out there? I hope this makes sense. See you all later. Bye-bye.